If you've been in enough group video calls, you've likely seen this. Someone forgets to mute, disrupting the conversation. Or you start talking, but sadly your mic is muted. It happens all the time. So we set out to create a solution and share it with the community as an open source project. In the description, you'll find everything you need to build and customize it yourself. So what do? We started brainstorming. It would be cool to have, right next to the keyboard, a large button that with a single press mutes your mic the moment your phone rings. But wait, what if it also lights up to let you know you're muted, so you never accidentally talk into the void? Some LEDs would do the trick. Because who doesn't love some LEDs, right? And while we're at it, why not include a wheel to control the volume? The same button could double as a dial to turn the volume up or down. Okay, we got our concept. Now we're gonna need a few things. Which component lets us both press and turn? That's straightforward. We need an encoder. We'll also need a microcontroller. Let's not forget the RGB LEDs. All of these elements must be integrated onto a single PCB. Next, we need firmware to read the encoder pulses, drive the LEDs, and communicate with our computer. We'll also design a practical, durable enclosure, available as a free download, 3D printable, and fully customizable. So hardware, prototyping, firmware, product design, and now we need the boss to approve the project. Time to assign tasks. Hardware. Assigned. Prototype assembly. Assigned. Firmware. Assigned. Product design. Assigned. Requesting approval from the boss. Well, perhaps it's best not to disturb him. He's probably busy. Okay, let's check on the progress of our project. Oscar is in charge of the hardware design. The first step was deciding which components to use. And among all of them, the most critical one for this project is the microcontroller. Using the full component library, Oscar created the schematic by interconnecting all parts according to their requirements and specifications. He then designed a layout and routed all the traces on the PCB, making sure there were no errors and that everything followed standard hardware design rules. Once our CAD tool confirms that the design is error-free, we send the Gerber files to our trusted PCB manufacturer. Let's take a look at the coding progress. Fran is in charge of developing the firmware, written in C, that we'll install on the microcontroller. On one side, it controls the LEDs and constantly checks the state of the mute button to determine what color the light should display. On the other, it reads the pulses generated by the encoder, and it also creates a virtual serial port over USB to communicate with our PC. On that computer, we'll need to install a lightweight piece of software developed in Python. It listens for commands sent through the virtual serial port to handle the requested actions, like muting and volume control. At the same time, it sends the current status back to the mute button, so it can update the LED colors accordingly. Fran's deep in his zone right now, so let's leave him to it and go check on the prototype assembly. When everything arrives, we begin assembling the prototype. In this case, Tanya starts by using a metal stencil to apply solder paste to the PCB. She then moves to our manual pick-and-place machine, where she carefully positions the tiny components using a precision arm with a vacuum head and a high magnification camera. She can rotate and align each part with great accuracy. For larger components, like the USB-C port, she uses tweezers to place them manually before the board goes through the next step, the reflow oven. In this process, the solder paste is heated, bonding the components permanently to the board. Once cooled, we head to the workbench for the final step, soldering the main component, the encoder, using a traditional soldering iron and tin. With that, the hardware is ready. This is looking great. Let's check how the enclosure design is coming along. Such a small product needs to be precise and solid. It has to survive the occasional rushed smack. Reinforce the moving parts, keep the delicate shaft secure, and make sure nothing wobbles. The top should be translucent, so the LEDs shine through. It should be simple to 3D print, easy to assemble. Oh, and it needs a window for the USB-C port. All right, two neat pieces, ready to go. Let's fire up the 3D printer. While we wait for the 3D printer to free up, it's time to load the firmware Fran created into the microcontroller. We'll use a tool called a pick kit. It connects our mute button to the computer through a 6-pin header. Don't forget, we also need to power our button via USB-C. That way, we can test the hardware and make sure everything works before putting it all together. Once the firmware is installed, we reconnect the mute button to our computer via USB-C. We need to install the driver so the computer recognizes the device. The mute button lights up purple, indicating it's in standby mode. Okay, looks like we've got it. I can hear the 3D printer is finally running. Let's check it out. Great, looks like it's printing the translucent part. This piece is printed in transparent PLA. Let's test it, see if it fits well, and if it lets the LED light shine through. Looks like it does. Cool. The 3D printer is still hard at work. Okay, it's just finishing up the case. Great. Now that we have everything and it's all working, let's assemble the mute button. But first, let's quickly review the components of our electronic circuit, starting with the USB-C port that powers our mute button and connects it to the computer. Then, we have three RGB LEDs that visually indicate the microphone status. There's the tiny chip that controls the circuit's voltage, our 32-bit PIC microcontroller from Microchip, and of course the encoder. All right, let's mount the PCB inside the case, making sure the USB-C port fits perfectly. We secure it with two screws so it doesn't move out of place. Then, we press fit the translucent cover until we hear a satisfying click. Now, we check that the cover rotates smoothly following the encoder steps and that the click works properly. The sound is pretty cool, right? And there we have it, our mute button, fully up and running. With this simple gadget on your desk, you'll never be the one causing an awkward moment during a video call. We hope you've enjoyed this project as much as we have, and most importantly, that it's useful to you. Subscribe and leave your comments, questions, and ideas to help improve it. Let's see how far we can take this together. We can't wait to see what you create. In the description, you'll find links to all the resources you need to bring this project to life. Thanks for watching.